that corruption is a cancer that affects the entire society in a myriad of ways. In Africa, the African Union also did recognize that corruption was a cancer. The net effect is that we now have international instruments that deal with the scourge of corruption. The UN Convention is as clear as it is explicit that in the fight against corruption, it is incumbent upon us to educate the people on the ills of corruption. We have, and countries continue to do that. They also recognize that it is important to ensure that we have schemes that reduce corruption through prevention, and also that we prosecute individuals who are engaged in corruption. The African Convention is a little more elaborate, both in what it prescribes and even a little bit more explicit in the title that it has, African Convention for Prevention and Combating Corruption. These instruments are useful and elaborate, and they send one and a singular message that corruption unchecked is a threat to democracy. In fact, one can dare say that many of the regimes that have been toppled in Africa through people power have had the fuel as the struggle against corruption. If you ask yourself what it is that brought the ancient regime in Tunisia down, it's because the people were tired with corrupt leaders. If you ask yourself what brought down the administration in Egypt, it was corruption. If you ask yourself what brought down the regime in the Gambia, it was corruption. And indeed, if you are to pose the question, what brought down the regime in Sudan, it was corruption. And the reason is because when corruption is at its full throttle, it undermines everything.